Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we are going to see about the XML configuration. If you haven't watched previous video of this video series, so I would strongly recommend to watch that video where we have seen what is the configuration and how we can implement the SQL Server configurations. So in this video, we are going to see about the XML configuration. So let's get started. So as per the requirement, we want to load the data from this table to this table. So this table is total having 26 record and the destination table which is having 105 record. And one more thing that you need to take care, if we can see in the source table the name column which is having environcat data type and the destination table that is having varcat data type. So now we need to load the data from this environcat data type name column table to varcat data type name column table. So go to on the SSDT and we'll try to implement this package first, and after that we'll be going to implement the XML configuration. So go to on the SSDT and let me use Dataflow task. Double click on this, and here we want to load the data from the SQL Server table. So we can use the OLADB as a source, and in the destination we want to load the data into SQL Server table again. So we have to use OLADB destination as well. As we have already seen, in the source we are having a column which is name column and that is having environcat data type. So we have to use the data conversion to load the data into varcat data type destination table. So here we can see this data conversion. So we have to use this in between source and destination. Now let me try to configure the source. So double click on this. Here we can see OLADB connection manager. So click on new. Here let me click on new. In the server name we can select this one, and after that in the database, so we want to make the connection with the SSIS test. Test the connection. Connection succeed. Click on OK. Again OK. Then again OK. So in the table, as we have already seen, so the table name which is emp data underscore destination environcat, so we need to select that table. So here is the table. In the columns we want all the column. Let me click on OK. Now we can select this source to the data conversion, so we can connect here. Now double click on this data conversion. Now we want to convert for this name and from this Unicode string to non-Unicode string. So we can select this and click on OK. So everything looks good. Now we can connect with the destination. Double click on this. And here we are going to use the same connection manager because table is available in the same SQL Server and in the same database. Now we can select the table. So the table which is EMP data underscore destination varcat. So here go to the mapping. So all the mapping is succeed, but instead of the name we want to use this copy of name column. So we can map this and click on OK. So now we can execute and we can check whether the package is executing successfully or not. So click on start. So here we can see 26 rows should be inserted in the destination. Stop this package, go to on the SSMS and execute it. So here we can see 131. So data is inserted from this source to destination. Now we need to configure XML configuration on this package. So how we can do that? Now here we can see inside the control flow, right click anywhere. If we are not going to see the second option, which is the package configuration, then you have to go on the solution, right click on this, and after that you can see convert to project deployment model. So if you are not going to see that option, then here you can see the option for convert to package deployment model. So you have to click on that. So this will be going to convert as package deployment model. After that you can click on this and you will see this option. So now go to on this package configuration, and here we can enable this and click on add. So once we add, then it will open this package configuration wizard. Let me click on next. Here it is going to ask the XML configuration file and the other options. So this time we are going to see about the XML configuration. So we have to select this option. So we want to keep our XML file in this location. So let me copy this, and here we can specify this path, and after that it will be going to ask the config file name. So the name you can specify anything, like testing dot config. After that you can click on next. Now it will ask which property we want to keep. So here we want to have this connection manager, so we can select this connection manager. And other options that you can also see the variable if you have any, and other properties that you want to select can be selected by this checkbox. So I'm going to select only the connection manager and click on next. Then we can click on finish. Then we can close this. Now let me try to execute this package. So this time it will be going to refer the same SQL Server, and as we can see previously it is 131, now it should be 157, that you could see. Now go to on the file. So this is the config file that we have. Now let me open this XML config file. So open in Notepad++. So here we can see the option for the connection string. So you can scroll in the right side. So this is the property for the connection string and the value which is in the right side. So this is the data source, and instead of loading in this SQL Server, we want to load this in this SQL Server. Everything will remain same in this case. Let me save this and close this. Go to on the SSDT and let me try to click on start. So it is executed successfully. Let me stop this package, go to on the SSMS, and here let me try to check it here. So now data is loaded in this SQL Server instead of the second one. So this is the XML configuration. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you have still any doubt, then you can comment in the comment box. I'll try to respond on your comment. And if you are having any scenario or any question, then you can also comment. I'll try to record a new video on the same. Thank you so much. Have a great day. See you in the next video.